Stay tuned for a physical media review with your host, Grim Grindel.
Hello, I'm Grim Grindel, and welcome to another episode of Physical Media Review. This issue, we'll be having a look at Batman Issue 1, which was, surprise surprise, Issue 1 of Batman. Without going into the full history of the character, which is actually quite interesting, and I might actually do it as a video at some point, Batman is Bart Simpson's answer to Batman, where his secret identity is Bart, and his superhero identity is Batman. The cover of Batman Issue 1 looks quite fantastic and has some holo foil on it, which is actually quite clever because it ties directly into the storyline of the main comic, which is entirely based around holo foil comics. To briefly sum up the storyline, avoiding any spoilers, Bart discovers that some comics are purposely being made with errors in order that they can be sold for larger sums of money as comics that were printed with errors. And so he suits up as Batman to go and investigate the crime. This choice of story suits the comic quite well. It allows Bongo Comics to both poke fun at the collectible nature of comics, and the nature of those people who collect the comics, and it also allows them to work in some self-referential humor into the comic book itself. However, this is unfortunately the only real good thing about the comic, and the occasionally enjoyable self-referential humor, this comic just doesn't have a lot going for it. The crux of the problem is it just doesn't seem to be aware of what it wants to be. It seems to be half leaning towards being its own thing, and half leaning towards being a parody of Batman. However, it neither tries to be its own thing well enough, and it neither tries to parody Batman well enough, with the only references to Batman being the most obvious references that someone that hadn't even seen or read anything to do with Batman could probably just make from their vague idea of what Batman was. Perhaps the most disappointing part of this half-assed emulation is the art style. The entire comic is basically entirely on model art. They could have gone wild with this and tried to make it look like a classic comic book, done speed lines or something, or done a bit more clever, interesting shading, but instead it just looks like a Simpson episode, which, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it just looking like a Simpson episode, but there's nothing exceptionally exciting about it looking like a Simpson episode. It's a difficult concept to explain, so instead I'm going to attempt to just show you what I mean. Look at this two-page spread of Bart swinging out of his treehouse with Milhouse looking on and swinging past the moon as his backdrop. It's just looks so bland. Half of the image is blue sky, and there's just nothing exceptionally eye-grabbing about it. If you compare this scene to basically any Batman comic that this Simpsons comic was halfway to parodying, they could have just done something really fantastic for it, even if it was only for this two-page spread. But they didn't. It just feels like this comic is largely a missed opportunity. I mean, just imagine if the entire comic was in this art style. That would look fantastic. However, this was one of the earlier Simpson comics, and they didn't really start to experiment with the art styles that much until the Halloween comics, which came out 2 years after this one. So I suppose we can't blame it too much. Maybe if they ever reboot the series, we can have it in a more interesting art style. The comic only comes with two extra things in it, the first of which being Bart's philosophy, which is basically just Bart saying man a lot. It feels like it was written by someone that had only ever seen one episode of The Simpsons, although it's attributed to Matt Groening, so I suppose it's legit, I guess, okay? And the second one is Bart's bottom 40, which is, I guess, a list of Bart's most disliked things. However, I'm not exactly sure what order they're supposed to be in, as in whether number 1 is his most disliked thing or number 40 is. And to add to the confusion, they just seem to be a little bit arbitrarily placed. For instance, number 1 is Lisa's saxophone, and number 40 is being an underachiever. And yet the haunting thought that Sideshow Bob will get out of jail again is all the way down or up at 29. Its weird placement, sort of not that close to number 1 or 40, makes it entirely difficult to tell which one of Bart's bottom 40 is the worst or which one is the least worst. Although, to be honest, I think I'm overthinking the list, and I think it was probably just thrown in there as an afterthought with not much thought at all. Overall, Batman Issue 1 is, to be completely honest, not that great. I wouldn't suggest you go out and buy it, but on the other hand, if you saw it in a $2 bin, I wouldn't attempt to persuade you not to buy it. It really just depends on how much of a Simpson fan you are. If you are a huge Simpson fan and just have to own it, I suggest you do own it, but lower your expectations significantly. Thanks for watching. I have been, and still am, Grim Grindel.
Simpsons Dudes and Dudettes. I have to announce to everyone that I am the number one Simpson fan in the world. I read your comics, buy your merchandise, watch your series, and love anything to do with The Simpsons. I would just like to say that many times I have seen letters in your comics from people who claim to be the number one Simpson fan, but then they ask silly questions which they should already know. Now I bet you think I'm a psycho! Well, what Duff is to Homer, what Krusty is to Bart, what Vishnu is to Apuna has a Peter Petalon, what the Sax is to Lisa, what the pacifier is to Maggie, what cooking and nagging are to Marge, The Simpsons is to me. I have but one question. Would I be able to speak with any of the cast that worked behind the scenes on The Simpsons? Your obsessed fan, Natasha, via email.
Natasha, I too love The Simpsons, but I think you need to get out more. As for your question, no.